Welcome back to Mortal Kombat.
Combatants, I present this latest creation of Shao Kahn. He is many warriors, their souls fused into one being. Behold, Ermac!
Be wary, Liu Kang. He is unlike anything you have fought before.
Liu Kang, you are the sole Earthrealm warrior to progress to this final stage of the tournament.
I am ready.
We are many. You are one. We will destroy you.
Round one. Fight!
Liu Kang, designated hero of the early Mortal Kombat games. He's the one who's officially supposed to have won MK1, MK2, and MK3 as well, I think. Bicycle kick! Oh, he interrupted my bicycle kick. Wah! Yeah, Ermac, he's got a whole load of telekinetic attacks. Oh, like that. Yeah, if you want to humiliate someone who's new to Mortal Kombat, play as Ermac and just grab them and toss them around telekinetically without ever letting them reach you. Ermac was originally a rumored secret character who didn't actually exist. In the boot-up sequence for the MK1 arcade cabinet, it'll give you a bunch of statistics on like number of times people have won the game, number of times they've fought Reptile. Yeah! And yeah, underneath Reptile Battles it said Ermac and then a number. And so people thought that Ermac was another unlockable enemy like Reptile, when in fact Ermac just stood for Error Macro. It's a way of tracking errors. But they later turned him into a real character due to all these rumors that there was a ninja in red called Ermac. Yeah, they put him into Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. Enhanced Bicycle Kick! Yeah!
Earthrealm will not fall into your master's hands.
He is a greater threat than anticipated. I will ensure he does not reach the final challenge.
Remember Bo Raicho's teachings. For my vision to be realized, you must not let emotion overpower you.
Your visions? What causes them?
My future self sent them to me, perhaps to ensure some outcome.
Or to prevent one.
He must win.
He must win. Those are my last words before I die. I believe it is you who must win. This amulet was forged by the Elder Gods. It cracked here in the present after my first vision. If we choose wisely, the future will be secured and the cracks healed.
I trust you will make the right decisions.
We must trust in the Elder Gods, Liu Kang.
Good. Show me more.
Do not underestimate me, Shaolin.
Round one. Fight!
Yeah, Liu Kang, she's not flirting. She's trying to murder you. Yeah, the Mortal Kombat movie added Katana as part of the events of MK1. But in that, Kitana wanted Liu Kang to win. They fought each other, but Kitana didn't fight very hard. You know, she rather let Liu Kang win. And yeah, she also gave Liu Kang a hint on how to defeat Sub-Zero. But in this, Kitana is one of the baddies. She is loyal to the Emperor Shao Kahn. And so, you know, she is, you know, fully on board with preventing Earthrealm from winning the tournament. You know, she's willing to go as far as, you know, effectively cheating and murdering a contestant to ensure Outworld's victory. Yeah, Liu Kang is quite obviously based on Bruce Lee. What with all the Yeah, he's got fireballs, he's got lots of quick hits, quick punches, lots of quick kicks, but he's also got some very cool long flying kicks as well. Yeah. He's also got my personal favourite, the bicycle kick. Oh, X-rayed again! Yeah, interestingly, in the first game, he didn't have a fatality. He had a finishing move, but it was non-fatal. You know, he was supposed to be a good guy, supposed to be a Shaolin monk. It was reasoned he wouldn't actually kill anyone. That changed quickly, pretty quickly from MK2 onwards, though.
Liu Kang wins.
I am impressed.
Do it.
Do what?
Kill me.
Why would I do that?
I came to kill you. I have failed my father, my emperor.
Shao Kahn is your father?
I have disgraced him. You must kill me.
I will not. This encounter never took place. You have disgraced no one. I hope we meet again. Under different circumstances.
Combatants, only one Earthrealm warrior remains. The Shaolin, Liu Kang. Is he ready to bear such a heavy burden? Earthrealm's fate is in his hands. Your opponent will be Scorpion.
I do not fear you, demon.
Fighting with Scorpion, the sorcerer Quan Chi.
You have already lost.
Round one. Fight.
Oh no, this is going to be horrible, isn't it? Scorpion and Quan Chi. They're going to be teleporting all over the freaking place, aren't they? That. What? What? How is that fair? What the hell? Oh, and I messed up the X-ray as well. Story-wise, it's cool that Scorpion and Quan Chi are together, since in this game they've made it that Quan Chi. They made it that Quan Chi is the one who resurrected Scorpion. His whole sort of function is to, you know, control Scorpion at the tournament. Just spamming fireballs. I daren't actually get near any of these guys. Oh, he put me in a trance. Yeah, and enhanced bicycle kick. Oh, missed my enhanced flying kick. Oh, a bicycle kicked over his head. Oh dear. Yeah, come on. Yes.
Quan Chi wins. Round one, fight.
Who came up with this idea of two against one battles? Really? Yeah, I'm gonna have to try and be very cautious. Lots of blocking, lots of hits of opportunity. Spam a couple of moves that actually work. Try not to mess up an X-ray like I just did. Oh! It's an enhanced version of that teleport attack that he does. Yeah, that's actually Liu Kang's throw. Liu Kang doesn't actually throw anyone, he just punches someone a lot and sends them flying. What?
Quan Chi wins. Round two. Fight.
Yeah, I really dig Quan Chi as a character. His use of all the portals, his various attacks, his chance ability. I think he's very cool. Just a nightmare to fight against, especially in a tag battle like this. Oh, that's really satisfying. Yes. Oh. Oh no! Ah, he got me to break my own neck. Come on! Come on! Nearly, 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 nearly. Oh, he swapped a scorpion. He'd have been dead if he hadn't swapped a scorpion. No!
Scorpion, ah!
You have already lost.
Round one, fight.
Okay, yeah, I'm back after a bit of a break. I decided I needed a rest, and I also decided to lower the difficulty setting because I really did not fancy doing this fight, you know, like five times in a row or something. Okay, yeah, this is quite obviously much easier. Yeah, the enemies block far less frequently, And also, oh dear, I did get x-rayed though. But yeah, they block less often and they tag out less often. On normal difficulty, they will swap characters quite frequently, and they'll do the special tag attacks when they do so. In this, you can pretty much pummel someone to death, and then you get the other character. They tag out quite rarely.
Liu Kang wins. Round two, fight.
I'll be turning the difficulty back up after I beat Scorpion and Quan Chi. You might think it's cheating a bit for me to lower the difficulty, but in fact, if you do the same fight, if you lose the same fight several times in a row, the game itself will lower the difficulty without telling you. You know, after like 10 attempts, suddenly the AI will become as thick as planks and like not block anything. And then after you've gotten several victories, the difficulty sort of gradually works its way back up again. If you get lots of wins in a row, the game gets harder and harder. If you get lots of losses in a row, the game gets easier. But by me manually turning down the difficulty and then turning it back up again, I'll be able to face the next opponent on the medium difficulty without worrying about whether the game is giving me an easy time. That makes me laugh, that one.
Liu Kang,
shoulder bitten by a skull. Ah, finally.
As I said, I do not fear you. I pity you.
You have done well, but the tournament is not yet over.
Goro.
What's a Goro?
Liu Kang. It has been years since an Earthrealm warrior has progressed this far. But the reigning champion is far beyond your ability. To the lair with you!
Not expect to fight in this tournament, but eventually even the Shaolin produce a warrior worthy of the Shogun.
I know who you are. I am ready for you.
I will give you a warrior's death.
Round one, fight!
Goro! In the Mortal Kombat movie, it was Johnny Cage that beat Goro. But since in the official plotline, you know, Liu Kang, is the winner of the tournament. It is actually Liu Kang that needs to fight Goro. Oh no! X-rayed, I'm doomed. I have turned the difficulty setting back up again, so this should be quite a tough boss fight. 53% damage. Yeah, that's Goro's X-ray. Goro is a boss. He's a boss enemy, so he doesn't have to follow the same rules as other characters. He doesn't have to be properly balanced. It's kind of weird that Shang Tsung isn't here watching this. He just created a portal and sent Liu Kang down to fight Goro. And waits to see who comes back. Of course, I suppose you could say that already happened. Ugh.
Round one.
Yeah, I mean, I suppose that already happened with Scorpion and Sub-Zero, but in that it was Scorpion that took Sub-Zero to the Netherrealm, rather than Shang Tsung or Quan Chi making that happen. Yeah, you need to jump to avoid those ground hits. In the early Mortal Kombat games, all the human characters were motion-captured actors, while Goro was a stop-motion animated claymation figure, like old original King Kong. You know, Clash of the Titans, Jason the Argonauts, all that. They did a really impressive job of it as well. Made a very cool boss enemy.
Seems the Shaolin trained a warrior greater than a Shokan.
Oh, the tension. Who's it gonna be?
One fight remains. Face me in Mortal Kombat.
So be it.
Round one. Fight.
Shang Tsung. Give me your best shot, pal. I can take it. Shang Tsung's based on Lo Pan from Big Trouble in Little China. And I am a big fan of Shang Tsung. I think he makes a really cool boss. You know, especially this MK1 version of Shang Tsung. You know, the obvious choice is to have a big giant guy be the final boss, but instead they did that for the sub-boss. And your final fight is an old geezer who's much more dangerous than he looks, because he's a powerful sorcerer, as well as having, you know, good martial arts skills. Yeah, we've both got fireballs, though Shang Tsung's fireball's actually flaming skulls. And as well as throwing them directly, he can also make them come from below, from above. It's the fight of the fireballs! Oh no, X-Ray, he's sucking up my soul! And he broke my skull for good measure. And now I'm fighting my evil twin! Yes, Shang Tsung has the ability to morph into you and gain all your moves and special attacks. In the early games, he could actually morph into everybody. In the fight with him, he would suddenly become Sonya, and then Kano, and then Sub-Zero. You'd fight the entire cast of characters. But that stopped once the games got into the 3D age. 3D graphics, it was too demanding to load in the graphics and animations and sounds, you know, for every character simultaneously. But yeah, this is fine. It makes sense thematically. He's using his sorcery to turn your own skills against you. Yes, this is it! Earthrealm is about to win Mortal Kombat!
Liu Kang wins.
Yes, sir! The check is in the mail!
Say it.
I concede.
Yeah!
Well done, my friend.
He has saved Earthrealm.
And they all slink off to Outworld, even Kano. Oh, and a touching little moment between Katana and Liu Kang. Uh-oh.